In his more than 50-year run as King of the Monsters, Godzilla has faced off against some fearsome foes, from longtime nemesis King Ghidorah to on-again, off-again frenemies like Rodan, Mothra, and Gamera, and even a mechanized version of himself and King Ghidorah at one point. Fans of the kaiju have debated for years about which of the many monsters Godzilla's gone up against is its true rival, and some say King Ghidorah, obviously, some say Mechagodzilla, two monsters that have gone up against Godzilla in multiple films with multiple different outcomes. But others point to a different beast, one that only faced off with the King of the Monsters once on the big screen, in a showdown that ultimately left Godzilla dead, despite him basically being All-Star Superman at that point. Destoroyah. Destoroyah is an incredibly interesting kaiju as far as origins go, even when compared to the wacky and wild backstories that some of the other monsters have in those original Japanese films. Specifically, Destoroyah has an incredibly interesting tie to Godzilla, as his creation was actually because of humans using the oxygen destroyer to kill the original Godzilla back in 1954. Destoroyah is actually a relatively recent addition to the kaiju universe, first appearing in Godzilla vs. Destoroyah in 1995, the final film in what's called the Heisei period of kaiju films, after which there was a 4-year break before films were put back into production in the Millennium period. In the film, Destoroyah emerges as a cataclysmic threat that the humans themselves actually brought about, like I mentioned. When the oxygen destroyer was detonated in 1954 to kill the original Godzilla, the effect of the weapon actually mutated a colony of prehistoric microscopic organisms that were living at the bottom of Tokyo Bay. After decades of exposure to the radioactive byproduct of the bomb, called micro-oxygen, the organisms were disturbed by underwater mining, prompting them to migrate to land, where they, you know, of course, began to wreak havoc. At some point, the microscopic creatures debuted a terrifying new ability that they could combine to form multiple amalgam creatures, and they did this, combining to create multiple beasts, which began to cause devastation across Tokyo. Using a cold temperature weapon actually designed for Godzilla to keep him from either exploding or melting down because he was overloaded with nuclear energy, the Japanese self-defense forces managed to hold off the juvenile destroyers until they combined to create one larger aggregate destroyer, and later still managed to transform into a version of that version, which allowed it to fly, basically allowing it to cause more devastation. Finally, after a showdown with Godzilla Jr., the creature morphed one last time into its iconic final form, standing taller on two legs than Godzilla himself. Destoroyah killed Godzilla Jr. before a final showdown with Papa Godzilla himself, who managed to defeat the demonic-looking terror with the help of the Japanese self-defense forces and their freezing weapons. Godzilla then gave in to the nuclear overload that was threatening to kill him and used it to bring Jr. back to life, which of course killed himself in the process. Destoroyah actually then went on to appear in the Godzilla Island TV series multiple times, but actually has not yet appeared in another Godzilla film up to this point. Despite a lack of screen time relative to the other kaiju that we know and love, Destoroyah's iconic appearance instantly makes him one of the most recognizable Godzilla villains, especially in his final form, where he stands more than 100 meters tall in this color that's a combination of black and dark red, with massive horns on a gargoyle-like head and massive red wings which also allow him to fly. This color combination is pretty consistent across all of his lesser forms too, which also look like the final form in the head mostly, despite looking more similar to kind of like crab or lobster-like creatures at the earlier stages than the final form, which just kind of looks like a demonic version of Godzilla. More than just his imposing look and physical size, Destoroyah also has a set of powers that make him extremely formidable, especially against Godzilla. First of all, the fact that he's basically just one big creature made up of dozens of smaller ones allows him to jump between his forms and gives him pretty powerful regenerative abilities. He also has two powerful energy abilities too, the laser horn, which is strong enough to slice through Godzilla's armored skin, and his most iconic power, the micro-oxygen beam, which is a powerful blast of the same stuff that made the oxygen destroyer so deadly to Godzilla in the first place. As far as when he might appear next, we actually might have a major clue of that. We know the oxygen destroyer is going to be in Godzilla King of the Monsters, so could we potentially see Destoroyah set up in that film for a future film in the franchise, whether it's Godzilla vs. Kong or potentially Godzilla 3? Only time will tell, but honestly, I would bet on it. Let us know in the comment section down below what you think of Destoroyah as a character, if you hope he shows up in this new run of movies, this new legendary MonsterVerse franchise, and, you know, who do you rank as Godzilla's most iconic foe? Personally, I do lean Destoroyah just because of the fact that he matches up so well because of the oxygen destroyer origin. I think that really makes him the toughest matchup for Godzilla, even though King Ghidorah has really gotten Godzilla's goat multiple times. That's going to do it for me here. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to smash that like if you like what you saw. Subscribe for more great content every single day, and consider turning on your notifications to be alerted every time we upload a new video. Signing off, this is CJ, and I'll see you next time